We're over here in Warren, Ohio with producer Vaughn and rapper India Raven at Headroom Recording. How's everything going today, guys?
Good.
Not too bad, Ronson. India over here, as usual, getting it in.
Yeah.
She wanted to come check out the spot to find out where she was going to have her song mixed.
Yeah.
So I had to let her know that, hey, you know, so this is where we're at. You know, we still got to do the skit. Actually,
maybe we'll shoot one more time over there in Boardman, and we'll do the skit over there.
Yeah, because I had it written out from last time.
Right, and then we'll mix, and then, you know, we'll come back. You know, well, you ain't got to come back when I mix it, but okay. I'm going to mix it over here.
Okay.
So we'll
okay.
do that. You can come out.
Okay.
Just put the headphones on the table on your right.
Yeah.
Well, India, what did you think about the difference between the studio at Method 8 in Youngstown and then the studio here at Headroom Recording in Warren?
Well, one of the major differences would be, like, the actual booth, like, because at Method 8 is the window, and, you know, where you can see back and forth for the producer and everything. And here it's like a separate room, but, you know, there's a camera in there, so the producer can see everything that's going on. So I kind of like that.
That was pretty cool to be able to actually be in the booth. And the acoustics was very tight.
Yeah.
And then the producer can see you on the big screen as you're in the booth. So that was really nice.
This essential differential of these words that you are, information, dedication, never stop, I keep on racing.
Vaughn, what do you think about the mixing here? You know, what were you trying to capture? What were you trying to pull out?
Well, the difference, I think the reason I like the mix here is because I'm used to being here. And actually, this studio, I've been here since 07. And I'm pretty much just accustomed to the room, you know, so it's plenty foam up. All the toys that I need are here. That's pretty much, well, you know, the basis of what, you know, why I like it here. Yeah. But Method 8 is nice, too, at the same time, but it's a totally different atmosphere. To me, even like India was saying about the booth, the reason we did the booth like that is so it's more of a personal touch. A lot of people don't like people to be looking at them. So with the camera being there, if you don't feel like you're acting, well, you know you're being watched, but it don't give you that feeling of being watched, you know.
Now, I got a chance to go in the booth myself, and you're absolutely right as far as the privacy is concerned. Because a lot of times people, they can sing, but then when they're in studio, they get nervous. They get, you know, just studio shy. I'll call it studio shy.
Uh-huh.
But it does have that privacy where you can just, you know, feel like you're there all by yourself. But at the same token, the engineer and the producer is actually seeing what's going on. They can hear one another. And they can see what's going on inside there, so it does make it really nice.
I've been recording so long like that. Really, windows are cool, but to me, I prefer a camera over a window any day. You know, and number one, most rooms that have cameras are more soundproof than rooms that have windows because most people don't do the double panes and the half-inch plate glass and all that with the 4-inch airspace and all that. So, you know, it's totally different, you know, totally, even tracking. When you're tracking vocals, you know, a little better, too. And what do you think about the vocals as far as, like, you know, how it felt even just tracking the vocals?
They felt different, didn't it?
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, that's pretty much, what I expect. And even as far as, like, it's just like the raw, the monitors is one major difference, too, like the V6s over here. Like, though they're a real flat response monitor when it comes to mixing and all that, too, so that's the other reason why I love mixing over here. You know, off the V6.
You know, because the Mac is battling on them. But I like the whole team like a battling on them. I'm better like battling on them. By the way, this single here is harder than your whole album. And I got them like, how come? You're so blessed. Well, it ain't coming from me. It's from God Almighty. Evidence to see. I can't do the song. And result, no debris. Sitting on that head.
They know my class.
On that head.
They know my stuff.
On that head.
They know my dad.
On that.
They know my mom.
On that head.
They
see
the queen.
On that head.
Actually, when I produce a song and I'm working on a song, I like to kind of like they say, live with the song. And good example, to me, the song's not done until until it's done, pretty much. And what I mean by that, when you feel, you know, if I listen to a song and it feel like it's, you know, full of holes and all that, like, you know, there's something missing, I'm always like, you know, let's find some way to, you know, plug those holes up, or, you know, or if we can't plug those holes up, we need to find a way where it don't feel like there's holes there, whatever it needs be done.
This part right here?
This essential differential of these words that you are information, dedication, never stop, I keep on racing.
You should stack all of that one more time.
This essential differential?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You're right. Yeah, I'm going to give you another track to do that on. Yeah, but, and actually you can, with a different tone, that's all. You know, to make sure it don't feel like the rest of the verse, so it stands out a little bit better.
Okay.
All right, here we go.
It's so incredibly credible, especially this essential differential of these words that you are.
Do it high. Differential, that's a
this essential differential of these words that you are info. Okay.
The way it's so incredibly credible, especially this essential differential of these words that you are information, dedication, never stop, I keep on racing. Okay. Seeing what you cannot see, the way it's so incredibly credible, especially this essential differential of these words that you are information, dedication, never stop, I keep on racing. Making this my occupation, I'm like passionate inspiration, and feel the end like revelation, so give me a standing ovation. I'm seeing what you cannot see, the way it's so incredibly credible, especially this essential differential of these words that you are information, dedication, never stop, I keep on racing, making this my occupation, I'm like passionate inspiration, until the end like revelation, so give me a standing ovation.
What up?
Hmm?
What up? Ad-lib, right? Another one, right?
Mm-hmm.
Here we go.
You ain't above me. Hold up, don't make me miss my plane. Slow up.
Like that?
What you think? I was trying to get it to match the first one, kinda. You gonna have to explain. Hold up, don't make me miss my plane. Slow up.
That's not fine, I think.
Okay.
Okay, come after that.
Explain. Hold up, don't make me miss my plane. Slow up. You better stay in your lane.
Do that again.
Mm-hmm. Don't make me miss my plane. Slow up. Don't make me miss my plane. Slow up. You better stay in your lane.
Okay.
Let's hear from back. You love my songs, you don't have to explain. Hold up, don't make me miss my plane. Slow up, you better stay in your lane. Roll up, now I don't do that, man.
Ain't nothing really wrong with that,
I don't do that, man. Okay. I don't do that, man.
So you gotta remember, too, you can do what you might be trying to bring out of it, you can do that with the ad-libs.
Yeah.
A lot of times.
Okay.
You know, so. Okay, you gonna keep going?
Woo, yeah, we gonna have to put this up.
Go.
You better stay in your lane, roll up. Nah, I don't do that, man. I'm like a whole nother entity, cause I don't really need you to convince you. See, I'm gonna be me and gonna be free. They think the determination's key.
Do it again.
You better stay in your lane, roll up. Nah, I don't do that, man. I'm like a whole nother entity, cause I don't really need you to convince you. See, I'm gonna be me and gonna be free. They think the determination's key. Roll up. Nah, I don't do that, man. I'm like a whole entity, cause I don't really need your convention. See, I'm gonna be me and gonna be free. They say determination, see? I messed up on determination.
Okay, here we go.
Roll up. Nah, I don't do that, man. I'm like a whole nother entity, cause I don't really need your convention. See, I'm gonna be me and gonna be free. They say determination, see? Roll up. Nah, I don't do that, man. I'm like a whole nother entity, cause I don't really need your convention. See, I'm gonna be me and gonna be free. They say determination, see? One more time. Roll up, nah, I don't do that, man. I'm like a whole nother entity, cause I don't really need your convention, see. I'm gonna be me and gonna be free. They say determination, see.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now you wanna do the auto-tune part?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on.
Signing now.
If you take one earphone off, it should be easier.
Okay.
That way you can hear what you're trying to do, and it'll put it right where it needs to be. Okay, here it comes.
I don't have time to. Okay.
Here we go.
Everybody wanna be on my team, cause I'm looking real fresh, real clean. Uh-huh. Take a fall back, get off of me. I don't got time to mess around. Got a Mac gun point, get on the ground. Every day you really love my sound. I better not catch you reciting it now.
Yeah, but don't do the one auto-tune part on this track, though. Just do some, like, you know, comments and stuff on this track about what you're talking about.
All right.
Not long, not statements, just words.
Okay.
Yeah, huh? Mm-hmm. If you can repeat a couple or something like that.
Okay.
Here we go.
When I step on the scene, everybody wanna be on my team. Oh, cause I'm looking real fresh, real clean. Uh-huh. Take a fall back, get off of me. I don't got time to mess around. Got a Mac gun point, get on the ground. Every day she really love my sound. I better not catch you reciting it now. My name is India, yeah, you know. I'm in the crowd, I stop the show. Oh, start a riot, crowd control. Oh, you ready? Okay, let's go. I got you slow, get money though. It's so easy, like a free throw. I won the game, no cheat code. Run around town, no CeeLo. You know these hit the max, I'm dialing on them. Violate your whole team like a ballin' on. I'm living good, I'm better like dialing on them. By the way, this single here is hotter than your whole album. And I got a light outcome. You're so blessed, well it ain't coming to me. It's from God Almighty, evident to see. I can't do it for them, Arizona, nope.
Where, I said, I got a mic, how come you're so blessed? It's not coming from me, it's from God Almighty. And I'm saying that it's evident to see that's who it's from. Yeah. Yeah. It's from God Almighty, evident to see. Yeah. I came through the storm. End result, no debris. Yeah. Okay. By the way, this single here is hotter than your whole album. Can you play one more time?
Is it evident to see?
Yeah.
Evident to see what?
Where I said, I got him like, how come you're so blessed? It's not coming from me, it's from God Almighty. And I'm saying that it's evident to see that's who it's from.
Oh, okay,
yeah.
Okay. I'm just trying to understand it. All right. Okay, you want to redo that?
Yeah.
Here we go.
Album, and I got him like, how come you're so blessed? Well, it ain't coming from me, it's from God Almighty, evident to see.
Yeah, I think that's better. Check it out.
You're so blessed. Well, it ain't coming from me, it's from God Almighty, evident to see.
That's better.
Yeah.
Right? Okay, now last part.
Well, it ain't coming from me, it's from God Almighty, evident to see. I came through the storm, end result, no debris.
Yeah, check that.
You're so blessed. Well, it ain't coming from me, it's from God Almighty, evident to see. I came through the storm, end result, no debris.
Like that?
Yeah.
Okay, let's do the whole verse.
Okay.
Hating on your hat, hating on your jacket, hating on your pants, hating on your shoes, and it don't matter what you say, you see what I'm saying,
yeah.
Too? It's just how you stress it, make it feel right.
Mm-hmm.
But that's why I say you can really incorporate anything you want into that.
So if I did something more than that effect, it'd be like, it'd kind of eliminate swag, right? So it's like pointing each and every one of them out.
Say again?
I said if I did something to that effect, it'd be like eliminating the word swag, because it's like you point out each individual thing.
No? Swag, and that's a real good example. Swag is the same thing as saying hating on your flow.
Mm.
You know, so, you know, like, you know, when you say hating on my swag, that's pretty, oh, that's really just saying hating on how you rap. You see what I'm saying? You know, so you can put that anywhere you really want to, you know, what I think is a good idea, everybody like to talk about clothes and money.
Yeah.
Right, you know, so I'm saying, you know what designers you like. you can talk about that. You know, if you carry purses, and you know people don't have all the purses and stuff, you know what you, you know what you have that mm-hmm. people like. That's what you need to talk about, and that's what's going, you know, that's what's going to give it that edge, you know. And then, like, you know, it don't matter what it is, you know.
Hating on my swag, hating on my chucks, hating on my dad, hating on my mom, cause she's the queen. You can't be on my team, I'm just 16.
Sitting on that hater rate, ha ha, that hater rate. Sitting on that hater rate.
Hating on my swag,
on that hater.
Hating on my chucks,
on that hater.
Hating on my dad,
on that.
Hating on my mom,
on that hater.
Cause she's the queen,
on that hater.
You can't be on my team,
on that hater.
I'm just 16,
on that.
Yeah, that is better. Let's hear that. And I'm not saying say it exactly like that, but it needs to, you know, it would be better, I think, to say something like that, because you get the haters that sit there and say, she ain't got no money, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah.
You know, but by saying that, you're setting, you know, even if you don't get paid, you're about to, you know. We're just doing a hook right now. We're doing a hater rate part, okay? Uh-huh. All right, here we go.
What's going on, India?
Nothing much here at the studio. Doing the verses to hater rate, trying to finish up, you know, got an intro to do. And finish up on a hook, so getting that done.
Now you got your producer Vaughn here, and you got the assistant engineer Scoop here working with you today. How's things going so far?
It's going pretty good. We're just trying to work things out. We just got started, so, you know, trying to get some work done.
Now you work pretty late, like for you to be going to school and stuff. You know, like what time is it now? About it's after 9, I know. After 9 p.m. and you're just now getting started, so then you got to go to school tomorrow, so that's a real trooper for you. But I see you got your lyrics up there.
Yeah.
So, you know, sounding good. The engineer just, you know, getting everything, tweaking everything for you.
Okay.
So, we're going to go back out. We'll see you later.
All right.
Well, what you about to say, Sue?
What'd you say?
Yeah, you can tell something going on. Yeah. It could have been having all that stuff open to them, plus doing that rewire, something is going on. Okay, let's do that again.
Is the
auto
going on?
Mm-mm.
Yeah, get my scoop look on. My hoodie on. It's now about the Jackson button.
Hey, Ray. Hey, Ray. You good?
Hater Ray.
You're losing the tone, the pitch a little. Hater Ray.
Hater Ray.
Yep.
Sitting on that hater rate.
Sitting on that. Let me hear that.
Sitting on that
hater
rate. Sitting on that
hater
rate. Sitting on that hater rate. Sitting on.
Do it again. Sitting on that hater rate. Sitting on that hater rate. Sitting on. Do it again. I want it to sound like that second one you keep hitting, that timing. You know what I'm talking
about?
Yeah. I know it's hard, but yeah.
Sitting on that hater rate. Sitting on that hater rate. Sitting on that hater rate. Sitting on that. I see you. Sitting on that hater rate. I think it's crazy the way that you stay in labor.
Get your time.
Don't you think you need some more drink to stay alive? I think it's crazy the way that you stay in labor. Sitting on. Don't you think you need some more drink to stay alive? I think it's crazy the way that you stay in labor. Sitting on that.
Okay, just keep going on the ad-libs now. Here we go.
Don't you think you need some more drink to stay alive? I think it's crazy the way that you stay in labor. Sitting on that hater rate. Sitting on that hater rate.
India Raven. I want to give a shout-out to my dad, my mom, Ronson and LaTonya, my two brothers, Jordan and Ronson. You know, all my family who supports me. Thank you for your support.
You got a music video coming out pretty soon after you dropped this hot track. What's that going to be like?
Wait, you want me to reiterate?
Yeah, reiterate.
All right. Well, I got a music video coming soon for Hater Ray, so be looking out for it.
Okay. You hating 24/7, 365. Don't you think you need some more drink to stay alive?
You want
to
say something? What? Tell us what's going on.
Well, just now getting done with the hook. About to start on my verses for Hater 8, so coming soon.
Are you about to start spitting some lyrics?
Yeah.
All right, now, your engineer already had to clean the window because people were spitting on the window more than they were spitting on the hooks.
Right. Yeah.
So you going to spit the hooks or are you going to spit on the window? Okay. And your producer, Vaughn, is doing an excellent job. Want to give a shout out to Vaughn, Scoop, and Brian West.
Shout out to Vaughn Williams. Shout out to Scoop and Brian West here at Method 8, doing big things.
I done told you time and time, keep hating, cause I'ma get mine. And I know that you gon' stress. Just keep sipping on that hater rate. Ha ha, that hater rate.
Okay, we have the Haterade skeleton done for the beat for India's song Haterade. And right now I'm going to just play some of the parts that we created. Right now I'm going to play you the drums. What we have here, this is the kick. Actually two kicks, it's tuned 808. Yeah, it's just pretty much just a straightforward basic tuned 808. Then we also have the snare and clap. Snare and clap. Okay, so that's that. Then we have, let's see here, we also have the cymbals. Here's your hats and crashes. Like I said again, this is the basic beat. So this is no way finished. We're going to build on this. So I'm showing you what we're building on. Here we go. Here's your hats and, you know, light crash right now. Okay, and then we just put a little hay sample in there. Just give it more of a little hip-hop feel. Everybody likes a little chance and all that. So there's a little hay to go with it. So that's just what we're doing from time to time. Actually, it's not going to go constant all the way through the beat. It's going to come in and out of different parts. So that's the hay. Okay. And now I'm going to play the whole drum beat together so you can hear the actual feel of it. So this is the whole drum beat together. Four bars, and that's pretty much the drum beat. Okay, now I'm going to show you the synthesizers that we added with it. This synthesized horns lead, India's lead, the one she requested. So here we are with those parts. And these parts, I'm not even sure what they are because I don't have them named, as you see. But I'm going to just play them one at a time and explain what they are. Okay. This is what? Oh, well, maybe I should turn it on so you guys can hear it. Okay, here we go. That's India's lead. The Haterade. Yep. That's her lead for Haterade, the hook lead, I guess you could call it. This is another sound. Brass. Yeah, it's a low brass. That's just like a little drawing brass sound that goes with it. Okay, and then we have, I believe this is going to be the stabs, like horn stabs or punches. That's all that is, okay. Then we got, what do we have here? What do we have here? Cornlick. What a majestic horn hit. Or horn lick. Superman! Alright. And here we have, let's see what we got here. That's just a little high-end lead. Just to sit there and make up a little melody to something to sit there. Just something in the beat. Melody, high end melody. Okay. Yep. And that's all that's going to be done. Actually, I'm going to put more of those in there. Okay. Different types, though. Maybe in different parts of the song. Okay. And this last thing we have is the organ, which I think I'm going to change. I may replay it and make it an actual B3 type organ. But this is a little M1 copy, you know, but I'm not crazy about the sound of this. But just want to show you guys what we're going to be building off of. You know? That's what the organ does. Okay, so now. Let's put all this back together so you can guys can see what the beat turned out like. The scratch of the first night. Laid up in the studio at Method 8. Let's see what we got.